Hi guys, this is Shekhar over here, and I'm going to be your faculty of sociology. So whosoever at this point of time have joined this class, you know, so I'll give you a brief introduction of what sociology is, and I expect and I request that all of you have watched two videos which is on YouTube. One is dated 19th of July, other is dated 20th of July. They are regarding, I have discussed the syllabus of UPSC in detail over there. Whoever has not, you know, watched that video, it's a humble request, please go ahead and watch those videos, because that will help you a lot. Not, it will not just, you know, tell you about the syllabus of UPSC, but it will also let you know how you should prepare for the examination. So lots of queries and doubts in your mind, especially about the strategy related issues, that can also be clarified. So I would recommend to all of the students attending this class that at this point of time you should, once this class is over, and those who have not seen those two videos which is available on YouTube, please go ahead and watch those videos. They are bit lengthy, they are 2-2.5 hours videos. Take your time, but ensure that you do it, because it will help you a lot. Coming to, you know, narration of today's class. So today is your first class. I'll give you a brief introduction to what sociology is, and then we'll carry on with the class. So if you people are aware of the syllabus of UPSC, you would know the first unit is sociology, the discipline. So after discussing what sociology is, brief introduction about all that, we'll directly move into the first unit, which is sociology, the discipline. And without wasting much time, the first unit of that chapter is modernity, social change in Europe, and emergence of sociology. So we'll get into that chapter. Okay. Now, you people may have doubt time to time, or you may have various queries. So first thing at this point of time, whosoever is seeing this, you know, video at live stream, please take down this number. Just bear with me. This is my personal number. My name is Shekhar. I am going to be your faculty of sociology. Please take down this number, please save it, and just ping me. Please WhatsApp me, just say, send a hi. And this is because, so that if you have got any doubts during the class, you can ping me immediately on this number, and this is how we'll interact for some days, and then we'll see how I can accommodate you people in the larger group, which is of the previous batch. Okay, we'll get into all that, but for the time being, can you please go ahead, save this number and send me a hi, so that I get to know who's attending the class, and I may, you know, if any doubts from your end, if they are coming while class as well, I may look into that and I may look to solve those queries. So I'm just waiting for your reply. Can you ping me, guys? Can you confirm me how many of you are watching this video? Chaliye, then let's move forward. I'll erase this now. Let us get into discussion of sociology. So, what is sociology? Sociology, this term has emerged out of two words: socius and logos. Are we clear? Sociology has emerged out of two words, socius and logos. Socius means companion, and logos means study of. Logos is a Greek word, and socius is a Latin word. So, this makes the literal meaning of sociology to be study of companionship. Study of companionship. Clear? Am I clear with that? Later, sociology emerged to be study of social membership. There was another definition. Do you find these two definitions satisfactory for sociology? Actually not. So, the process of evolution of the definition continued, and the new definition after this became, just bear with me, analysis of structure of relationship emerging out of what? Analysis of structure of relationship emerging out of okay, I'm really sorry about this. Just bear with me. Just bear with me. So basically, until then I'll speak. I'll write it on the board again. So basically, the new definition of sociology became analysis of structures of relationship constituted out of interaction within society. Analysis of structures of relationship emerging out of interaction. ठीक है. Now does the definition at this point of time appears to be quite convincing to you? The answer to that would be no, not yet. What does this mean? What does this mean to you? There are other definitions as well. So the definition for sociology, it kept evolving from time to time, and then new definition was perceived to be systematic study of social groups and relationships. Sociology at that point of time was perceived to be systematic study of social groups and relationships. तो अभी तक आपको ये तो आइडिया लग रहा है, यू आर एटलीस्ट गेटिंग एन आइडिया दैट सोशियोलॉजी इज गोइंग टू स्टडी सोसाइटी और सोशल मेंबरशिप, सोशल ग्रुप्स एंड वॉट एल्स, सोशल रिलेशनशिप्स एंड देयर स्ट्रक्चर विच इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड आउट ऑफ इंटरैक्शन अकरिंग इन सोसाइटी. क्लियर? So all this having said that, it is still not, you know, convincing enough, it is still not satisfactory enough. And human behavior, study of human behavior also became subject matter of sociology. So the next definition of sociology became study of society or social life, its groups, interactions and behavior. Now over here, social life covers humans' behavior as well, especially in social context. It covers humans' behavior as well, especially in social context. Clear? Now later, sociology was seen as a subject which emphasized on pattern of interactions. Sociology emphasized on patterns of interaction. Jo various interactions are occurring in society, how are they interrelated? What is their impact? And is there, does there any pattern, is there presence of any pattern that exists in society? Clear? Any pattern of interaction. For example, in feudal society, there was a feudal lord, and then there was a serf or vassal, and they had lord-vassal relationship. So, a pattern, and they would interact with each other. So, they'll see what is pattern of their interaction, how a lord behaves towards or acts towards his or her vessel, at the same time how the vessel serves the lord, and that various interactions are observed, and based on that, if there is any pattern, then that pattern is drawn from that observation, and then a theory is generated accordingly. And that theory is about how sociology, or you know, how sociology or how society is acting. Is there any pattern, any commonality? Why could you stimulate thought process that why did that happen? Why is society, why is the subject observing a pattern? And if subject is observing a pattern, there is a word hidden: observation. So why is subject observing? Because the discipline is trying to be scientific at this point of time. Clear? Do we have any doubts over here? I don't think we have any doubts. If we have got any doubts, can anyone ping me? Can anyone WhatsApp me on the number which I had given? Any of you people, if you guys are the late joinee, if you have joined the class late, then once again I'll repeat this for you. My number is 7042702742. So any of you want to interact to me directly at this point of time during the class, whatever I am teaching you, if you have any problem with that also, then please go ahead and ask me the query. The number, I'll highlight this once again. I hope you are able to see it. 7042702742. Just bear with me. I'll in fact erase it from here and write it on the other side. Clear? I am still waiting for your ping. If you can ping me. Okay, so I have not received any ping yet, but if any of you people face any doubt, because I, my style of teaching is that I want to get into your brains what you are thinking, because see, sociology is such a subject, guys, where social thinking has to be ingrained or has to be imparted in a student. That way any kind of question comes in UPSC and you will be able to tackle it. Clear? And also if the class is interactive, it becomes better for a teacher as well and for a student as well. That way if any doubts are emerging into your mind, it will come to me, and that way I will clear it immediately, so that you know one doubt does not lead to another. Clear? And sociology is conceptual subject, so the focus has to be on clarity of concepts, and that is why interaction is needed. Done? Having said that, once again, so I had explained you what we were looking at the definition of sociology. Clear? Now let's see what to do and how to do. When I spoke about, you know, observation of patterns of society, what does that mean? That means that certain questions are to be inquired by the subject about the society. Certain questions are inquired. What are those inquiries? How and why society emerge? How and why society emerge? How and why society persists? How and why society persists? Clear? And last question is, how and why there is change in society? Take a society change. Okay, so what are these questions? I'll be writing over here. First question, how and why society emerge? You observe patterns to find out how and why society emerge. Then reasons for persistence of society, how and why society persists. Clear? And last is going to be how and why changes. So that is why I always convey my students that whenever, you know, we talk about society or especially sociology, you have to understand sociology is a subject, a discipline that studies society, and it studies society with a view of continuity and change. So you would see great books written on about societies, and you, for example, there is a book written on Indian society by Nadeem Hastain. And what is the name of that book? Indian Society: Continuity and Change. That means once society keeps changing, keeps evolving. So there are certain features which continue to exist in society. At the same time, certain features or structures or relationships which are lost. So that what happens? New structure or new relationship, new structure of interaction, new basically new pattern in society emerges. Therefore, these three questions, we do pattern observation to answer these three major inquiries. Clear? Therefore, getting back to definition of sociology, and pattern is figured out through method of observation. And when I said observation, what does this that highlights in itself? That the study is going to be scientific in nature. The study is going to be scientific in nature. Clear? Therefore, having said all this, if I say that sociology is, you know, study of social groups, structures, relationship, or I shall say systematic study of human behavior, social life, social group, and patterns of society. Is that satisfactory enough? I would say no. Why? Because sociology is also a discipline which is scientific in nature. It is science of society, it tries to study society scientifically. Clear? And apart from that, there are so many social institutions in society. Sociology looks to do what? Looks to study that as well. When I say social institution, what does that mean? Any idea? When I say social institution, what does that mean? Okay. What are they? Religion, polity, education, economy, family. What are they? They are social institutions. Social institutions. And what do? You know, they ensure that the existing pattern of society continues to exist. Therefore, they constrain their rules, laws, and norms on individuals, social members. And that is why study of social institution is also subject matter of sociology. Clear? Look at this: religion, polity, education, economy, and family. Done? Okay, so who's this? Hello, can I have your name? Not religious institute as such. Hi Saurabh. Not religious institute. Religion as whole, it is a social institution. Polity as whole, it's a social institution. Okay, the concept of religion, family, it is one type of social institution. Clear? Okay, getting back to you, Saurabh. So, your doubt is that why so? Because that is what they are called. What are they? They are an institution. What did I define social institution? Social institution are that body of society which looks to confirm and which looks that, you know, members of society which ensures that those patterns keep existing. Therefore, they constrain the existing order, the existing rules and norms on you. Now, let's understand it through an example. When you take birth in society, you are part of the first institution which you recognize is family. Hai na? So, the pattern which a family has, that pattern is imparted to you. You interact with the family when you take birth in society, you interact with whom? With the family, isn't it? And that pattern is imparted in you, the individual. Clear? Therefore, over here, see Saurabh, he took birth. Right now Saurabh is a baby. Okay? At this point of time, when Saurabh has taken birth, he is not a social animal, he is not a social being, he hasn't socialized with anyone else. no interaction in society as of now. He is just a biological being. Then interaction starts with mother, gradually with father, and after 2-3 years interaction starts with family. You basically interact with the family, so you learn the patterns of family. Aapko aapki maa sikhati hai bete kya khana hai kya nahi khana hai, what to eat what not to eat, isn't it? Your father teaches you how to play, how to walk. Gradually you grow. The first rules, norms, which you stick to, which you learn, which you adhere, is that of your family, isn't it? So what is it doing? What is family doing? Existing rules and existing order of society, it is teaching you. And everything, it is constraining it upon you. Aap pe dal raha hai, aap pe constrain kar raha hai. And that is what all of these do. Economy constrains you. Education, it does that. Polity, it does that. And religion, it does that. Clear? Okay, Saurav. Good. And that's how I want the class to be interactive. Thank you that you people interacted. Clear? Namira, if you have any doubt, anytime, you can ask me as well. Now let us move forward. Let's not waste time. ठीक है, and don't worry, ये social group interaction जो भी sociology के definition में आएगा ना, I'll dictate it to you as well. At this point of time, I just wanted you people to understand all of this. Am I clear? चलो, let's move forward. And I hope that you have attended the class today from the beginning, right? Or did you join in the between? Did you miss anything? Can all of you confirm that through the WhatsApp message? Can both of you confirm this? Okay, Saurav, so you did not miss anything, and Namira, you had missed something. So basically, I was going through definition of sociology. I'll just give you brief introduction. I'll erase this now. So we were discussing about sociology. Sociology came out of this word socius and logos. Logos is a Greek word and socius is a Latin word. Socius means companion. Logos means study of. So initially sociology emerged to be, literal meaning could be perceived as study of companionship. But is this the correct definition of sociology? The answer is no. Lots of elements are left. So sociology, the further people, if go ahead people discuss and debate, then sociology could be seen as study of social membership. Study of social membership. But even this is not satisfactory. So people went ahead and people further defined sociology to be analysis of structures of relationship constituted out of interactions in society. Structure of relationship which is built by interactions that is occurring between various groups and people. So isse group word aa gaya. Further people perceived sociology to be study of human behavior, social group and interaction in social life. एंड ये सब मिलता रहा, फिर एक वर्ड सिस्टमैटिक एसोसिएट हो गया, सिस्टमैटिक स्टडी ऑफ ह्यूमन बिहेवियर, सोशल इंटरैक्शन, सोशल ग्रुप, परसीव टू बी सोशियोलॉजी, ठीक है। फिर पैटर्न ऑब्जर्वेशन, सोशियोलॉजी लुक्स टू ऑब्जर्व पैटर्न इन सोसाइटी, सो द डेफिनेशन इमर्ज टू बी इट इज यू नो एनालिसिस और स्टडी ऑफ पैटर्न्स ऑफ सोसाइटी, ऑफ सोशल ग्रुप्स एंड वेरियस इंटरैक्शन, ठीक है। बट नन ऑफ देम आर कंप्लीटली सैटिस्फैक्टरी। इफ यू से दैट देयर इज पैटर्न ऑब्जर्वेशन इन सोसाइटी, ऑब्जर्वेशन रैशनैलिटी, दीज रैशनल अप्रोच ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट, दैट मीन्स द सब्जेक्ट इज साइंटिफिक इन नेचर। See, you don't have to memorize. Have you understood this? I'm making you understand how we get to the final definition. You just have to understand it. That way you will get to know these are the elements of, you know, the definition. These all aspects sociology as a discipline gets to study, looks to study. These are subject matters of the discipline. Clear, Saurabh? Clear? We have not arrived at the main definition which I am going to give you, which I am going to come to now. Clear? I hope whatever I am speaking, you are also making notes of it. So, you being a smart student, you can use it according to the question, wherever and however you want. And I believe ki ratta mar is not memorizing, is not the right approach if you do not understand things. Why have you joined the class? Tell me one thing, there is enough content available in the market, isn't it? So what can I do different for you as a faculty? Tell me that. I have to teach you in a manner that you understand lots of things, right? So first focus on understanding the essence of the content, and then you know memorizing part can be thought later. Chalo. So Namira, I was repeating this for you. So that is what we were discussing. But as I told you, none of these definitions, they are completely satisfactory. And time to time, I'll be giving you people dictation as well. When I say that I'll dictate, then please ensure you've got your pen and notebook and you start writing, you start making your notes. Now, as I was talking about sociology being a scientific discipline, sociology approaches to study society with scientific method, because sociology as a discipline, guys, it emerged post Renaissance era, post Enlightenment period, around 18th, 19th century, because that time was known as upheaval time. When we get into the syllabus of sociology, the first chapter, modernity, social change in Europe and emergence of sociology, we'll get to know about all this, you'll learn about all of this. But for now, you just wait, okay? You just imagine that if sociology has emerged around that time, because there were lots of changes which were occurring in society at that point of time, and you know there were a group of intellectuals in Europe who believed that now there is need of a distinct discipline which should emerge to study these changes in society, because society had become complex in nature. Clear? Clear? So around that time, science was seen as correct method to seek true knowledge. Scientific method was seen as appropriate method to seek a body of knowledge. After Copernican revolution, you know what is Copernican revolution? Nikolai Copernicus, he had proved, he disagreed with church's stand, and he had proved mathematically to the society that world is universe, our solar system is heliocentric and not geocentric, if you remember. By heliocentric, I mean sun being at the center of the solar system and other planets revolving, earth revolving around the sun. At that point of time, church had a stand that earth is at the center and sun revolves around the earth. Clear? But Copernicus had proved it mathematically, scientifically. Also, Europe, you know, it was suffering from past 1300 years. That is called as Dark Age of Europe. That period, time period, is called as Dark Age of Europe. People were waging wars, based on service to religion and service to church. There was no rational thought process in society. But then happened Renaissance. During Enlightenment period, during Renaissance period, people started questioning society. We'll get into all that. We'll look into that modernity when we get into that chapter. I'm just trying to right now go through definition of sociology. So what I'm trying to say, that science at that point of time was being celebrated, because science had changed life of individuals. It had improved the life of individuals. So people started believing in science. People, Enlightenment era, during Renaissance period, there were two, three value systems that emerged. Spirit of inquiry was one of them. Question everything. Rationality and reasoning was another one. Empiricism and observation, it was another one. Based on that, science as a subject is based on that. This is scientific method. Therefore, every discipline, they had this feeling that, to be closer to the truth, one should adopt scientific method. Because scientific method is a correct approach. Adopting scientific method in a discipline, it is a correct approach, to pursue a body of knowledge. When it was finally decided by the early sociologists, the founding fathers of the discipline, that it will be a science of society, it will study society in a similar manner how natural science, or I shall say physics, physical science like physics, chemistry and biology, looks to study elements of nature. Similarly, with same approach, sociology will look to study elements of society. So basically, they saw sociology to be science of society, or they gave it a name of social physics. Clear? And this bunch of intellectuals, who believed that sociology should study society with a complete scientific approach, were called as modernist. Were called as what? Were called as, sorry, not modernist, my bad, positivist. Were called as positivist. We'll get into all of this when we get into second chapter, which is sociology and positivism. Sociology as science. That is your second unit. In sociology as a science, we are going to look into all this. Now, getting back to definition of sociology. Therefore, scientific study is also included in definition of society. Now, the final definition I am going to reveal for you people, please write. I am going to dictate. Please be ready and please write. Sociology is, and then write under double quotation. Please write under double quotation. Sociology is the systematic the systematic and scientific study of human behavior. Sociology is the systematic and scientific study of human behavior in social context. In social context, human behavior ka ek individual context hota hai aur ek social context hota hai. For example, I drank water because I was feeling thirsty. I just acted like a biological being. So this was a human behavior, but at individual level. But then me drinking water could have a different meaning as well assigned with it. For example, I am teaching my students. I need to be interactive and energetic. Now just try to, you know, connect this and try to think over it. I need to be energetic. Hai ki nahi, isn't it? For that, what will I do? I need to be on my toes. I need to be focused. Anyhow, you're not sitting in class. Due to COVID situation, we are having online classes. So in order to maintain my focus, time to time I need to drink water. Now, when I drink water for this purpose, then what happens? That means I am thinking, I am concerned about my student. In order to deliver my lecture in a better manner, I am drinking water. Now suddenly I am not acting like a biological being. I, Shekhar, your faculty, your teacher, has suddenly become social being, because socially I am connected. This is a class, this is a social environment, you have come to me to learn. KSG is an educational institute, and what is anything which is educational comes under is a social institution, isn't it? So what am I trying to do? I am trying to socialize with you in a better manner by teaching you, by being energetic while I teach, by being interactive while I teach. Why am I giving you this example? I am giving you this example so that you can understand in better manner when I say human behavior in social context. And by doing that, I am delivering a better lecture. So this giving this example was also a social behavior. Human, it was a human behavior, but in social context. Samajh mein aaya? So that's why it is systematic and scientific study of human behavior in social context. Theek hai? Apart from that, there are so many groups in society which sociology is interested in learning about. Caste, people of one community, say Dalit people, Brahmins, say black people. I am not calling them black, I may call them Afro-Americans, but it is a name given to them, isn't it, to a race. Sociology looks to study that. Say tribal people, say Munda tribe, or people of a village in Mysore, which a famous thinker M.N. Srinivas studied. Hai ki nahi? So what are these? They are groups. So sociology looks to study social group. Men accumulated together, men over here is, you know, not gender specific, man as a entity, people, men and women, theek hai, living together in a similar social setting form a group. Main sabki definition likhaunga abhi, aap tension mat lo. So that way sociology became study of social group as well. Human behavior in social context you have understood, social group you have understood. इंटरैक्शंस मैंने पहले ही बता दिया, ठीक है, इंस्टीट्यूशंस मैंने बता दिया, एंड स्ट्रक्चर. वर्ना सिस्टम क्या था? वर्ना सिस्टम वॉज अ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सोसाइटी वेयर ब्राह्मण वॉज सिटिंग एट द टॉप फॉलोड बाय क्षत्रियास, फॉलोड बाय वैश्यास, एंड एट द बॉटम शूद्रास. सो दैट वॉज वन स्ट्रक्चर, द वे द लेयर्स इन विच सोसाइटी इज ऑर्गेनाइज और द स्ट्रक्चरिंग ऑफ सोसाइटी. क्लियर? सो हाउ रिलेशनशिप्स आर स्ट्रक्चर्ड इन योर फैमिली वुड बी हैविंग अ स्ट्रक्चर. इफ यू आर कमिंग फ्रॉम अ पेट्रियार्कल फैमिली, द लीडर ऑफ द फैमिली वुड बी अ मेल एंड वुड बी एंजॉइंग द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ पावर इन दैट फैमिली, इजंट इट? सो दैट अ पेट्रियार्कल फैमिली विल हैव अ डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर इन कंपैरिजन टू अ मैट्रियार्कल और मैट्रिलिनियल फैमिली. We learn about all this when we get into 9th chapter of your unit 1, which is fundamentals of, which is a family and kinship. Now I expect all of you people, whoever is attending this class, please download your syllabus copy. At the same time, I'll give you a sociology brochure as well. If you require, I can send it to you. Do you people have, can you confirm this? Do you have access to syllabus of sociology? Both of you, can you confirm that? Saurav, can you confirm that? Namira, can you confirm that? No issues. In that case, guys, by evening I'll send it to you. Just remind me once in the evening. Saurabh, are you there? Chalo, anyways. So that is where we come to the main definition of sociology. Please write now, I'll dictate. The systematic and scientific study of human behavior in social context, comma, social group, comma, institution, comma, structure, comma, patterns of society and society as a whole. I hope you guys, while I'm dictating, you guys are writing. I'll repeat this once again for all of you. The systematic and scientific study of human behavior in social context, the systematic and scientific behavior, the systematic and scientific study of human behavior in social context, comma, social group, comma, social institutions, comma, structures, comma, relationships, comma, patterns of society and society as a whole. When I say society as a whole, it consists of social group interacting amongst each other and their organization. When I say society as a whole, it basically means groups, okay, interacting, interaction, social group and social interaction, groups interacting among themselves and also how they are organized, their organization. Clear? I hope there is no doubt. Namira or Saurav, if you guys have any doubts time to time, please do let me know. Neha, are you not attending my class? Namira, can you confirm me what was the last no sir about? Do you have any doubt that no was no sir, no doubts, or do you want me to repeat the definition? You were not able to write it. Namira, I am waiting for your reply. Thank you, Namira. Chalo. Done. Let's move forward. Now, so we'll write the definition on the board once so that it becomes easy for us to discuss. So we'll see it as a, what is sociology? Sociology is systematic and scientific study of, just focus on this word, systematic and scientific study of behavior, human behavior, human jaan ke chhod diya hu, to social behavior maan lo, social context mein, so basically social behavior, theek hai, baaki cheez pe focus karte hain, social groups. Institutions, structures, relationships, and society as whole. What is society as whole? That I have already explained to you. Now we will try to see all these mnemonics, all these jargons, because these are sociological terms which will be, you know, coming time to time. So you need to know them individually so that kabhi samajhne mein problem nahi hoga. Explicitly they are not in your UPSC syllabus, but that is what, you know, people complete 3-4 units and that is when they do, and they realize that they have almost finished paper 1 or at least half of the syllabus, and they are not aware what social institution is or what is meaning of social group as such. सो वी विल नॉट गेट टू गेट इन टू ऑल दैट. हम लोग बिल्कुल बेसिक से समझेंगे. एंड व्हेन आई से बेसिक आई मीन व्हाट इज सिस्टमैटिक स्टडी. लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम व्हाट इज सिस्टम. दैट इज द फर्स्ट वर्ड ओवर हियर व्हिच इज सिस्टमैटिक. सो वी विल स्टार्ट विथ सिस्टमैटिक स्टडी फॉर यू पीपल. क्लियर? Any idea what systematic study is? Any basic idea? Look, sociology is a subject for which you do not need sociological background, or say for that matter even humanities background. If you are someone who is actually coming from engineering background or you know non-sociological background, you can still be very comfortable with the subject. Okay, what systematic study actually means? Can anyone of you can do you have any idea? Can you reply me in the chat box if you've got any idea? Yeah, you're typing something. Yeah, Saurabh, you're typing something. How group behave? No, no, I am asking about systematic study. You are very close. Systematic study looks at relationship. Okay, when I say systematic study of society, here if I say about systematic study, the context is society, systematic study of society, not group, how groups behave, but it looks at relationship. ठीक है, सोशल रिलेशनशिप्स. आप पैदा होते हो, एक और मेंबर है आपकी बहन पैदा होती है, आफ्टर 3 days देयर इज रक्षाबंधन. सो लेट्स टेक दैट एग्जांपल. यू टेक बर्थ, आफ्टर दैट मे बी योर सिस्टर हैज आल्सो टेकन बर्थ ऑन दिस अर्थ एंड बोथ ऑफ यू बिलोंग टू द सेम फैमिली सेम इंस्टीट्यूशन. ठीक है, नाउ यू शेयर अ रिलेशनशिप. ठीक है, बट you within the same family which is one institution, you may be sharing a different kind of relationship with your mother, a separate kind of relationship with your father. What does that mean? That means that although there exists relationship, there is one, this gentleman Saurabh. Theek hai, let's say Saurabh as a father, Saurabh has a mother, and Saurabh has a sister. Yes, yes, systematic study is study with purpose, but what is the purpose? When I say systematic study, in the definition of sociology, the context of systematic study is systematic study of society. Systematic study of society. Clear? So systematic study of society means looking at relationship and finding its attribute. The relationship that Saurabh has with father may be different with mother. So attribute would change, no? Motives, meanings, all of this will change. So what systematic study does is that at first stage it looks at relationship to yahan likha hi hai. what systematic study does, that it looks at relationship. Let's be very clear about this. And once it looks at relationship, it tries to find attribute. Try understanding this flowchart. Finds attribute. Okay. Looks at a relationship, finds attribute, and then by finding attribute, it may find cause and effect. Attribute of Saurabh, Saurabh's relationship with his sister would be different than attribute of Saurabh's relationship with his father. Now, why is it different? Getting into those details. So, cause and effect. And if it is different, then what happens? So, maybe he is scared of father. Or maybe he admires his father. At the same time, maybe the relationship with his sister is friendly. He doesn't admire her, he doesn't look up to her, but he loves her more than his father. Completely, and all of this is dynamic. For different individual, it may be different. For Mahira, it would be different. For Namira, it would be different. For Neha, it would be different. For Satish, it would be different. For Fatima, it would be different. Clear? So, once you find the cause, that is why you need to find cause and effect. So, sociology, whenever it studies society, it believes in causal effect analysis. And when we get into social thinkers, when we start learning about Emile Durkheim, Max Weber, these are your prescribed social thinkers, then you will get to know about this fact as well. You will get to know about this fact as well. Clear? Am I clear to you all? I hope I am. No, it's not about group. Okay? I hope now it is clear. This is what systematic study does. Fir kya hoga? If you find out attribute of relationship, then if you find out cause and effect, then you will draw a conclusion. Jaise school mein karte the systematic study. Saurabh and Namira and Neha and Fatima, Satish and Rakesh. All of these are my students attending the class. Now, why are you wasting your time sitting in this class and listening to this boring person? Why are you? Time is very crucial. You are an aspirant of civil services. Why are you just wasting randomly your time and listening to this individual who is complete stranger to you? You've seen this face for the first time in your life, and this face is a complete stranger to you. And time is so precious, why are you wasting it on this individual? Now, I need to understand this. You know, I need to understand our relationship. So, I'll find, look at this relationship which we are sharing. I'll find attribute. I am the teacher, you the student. Meanings assigned over there. I need to teach sociology because you are aspiring for civil services. You have opted sociology as an optional. And you have enrolled in my class. So, you have vested my faith in me. So, as a teacher, it is my responsibility to be as interactive, as dynamic as I can. To make your life easy. To give so many examples so that you can understand things, because book anyhow content is available in book, but it is what is important. You want someone else to make you understand that. That is why I am doing this job. So I am for my relationship with you. I am a teacher. You are my student, and I have to teach you. So I have to behave in a different manner. I have to respect this relationship. At the same time, you are the student, I am the teacher, I am your teacher. So your attitude towards me is in a different way. You ask your doubt, at the same time, you know, you have this devotion, my sir is teaching me, I'll give this time, my crucial time to him, and I'll learn from him so that I can clear the examination, I can have, you know, competitive advantage over my competitions, because this exam is a competitive exam. And if I relatively do good, I'll clear the examination. My optional has potential to score more than 300 marks, and I want to grab those 300 marks. So that would be your attribute. And you see the process. I also discussed attribute as well as, so your attribute is student, my attribute is that I am teacher, and then we are acting in a certain manner, we are behaving in a certain manner. That is cause and effect. We are trying to know the cause, that why you are sitting, you are wasting your time. Study was about why, what was study about? Study was about why you people are wasting your crucial time over this stranger. So we understood the cause. We understood, if you people don't like me, you will not come tomorrow, or you will withdraw your name from the enrollment. In that case, effect will be different, that tomorrow there will be no class, and in that case, conclusion will be something else. But ultimately what will happen, we will come to a conclusion that I am wasting this time because this stranger teaches well and I learn from this stranger. So this is the process which we discussed at this point of time through that example. That was systematic study. That was systematic study. Once, and do we do this randomly? No. All of this we do keeping scientific perspective in mind. Keeping scientific perspective in mind. So when I say keeping scientific perspective in mind, so that is where I will move next to understand what is scientific study. Theek hai, systematic study to samajh mein aa gaya. Now we will move to what is scientific study. So keeping scientific perspective in mind, matlab ki science basically, guys, science believes in construction of body of knowledge, construction of theory coming out of facts as well as theories coming out of reasoning. Observation, inductivism, supremacy of fact, inductivism, which means supremacy of fact. So say the process of classroom, the study, that why you people are wasting time, if we get back to that study. So now how a systematic study will be, you know, having a scientific perspective, that the management of KSC sends certain questions to you. How was the class? Was it good? Was it bad? How was the teacher? How was his command of the language? How was his body language? What was he sounding interested in you? Was the class interactive? Did he cater your doubts? Then maybe set of questions, based on that you would reply. Based on that, observations will be made. Okay, so are you satisfied with the class? Yes. Did you find teacher intellectual? Yes. Is he capable enough to make you understand complicated things through simple example? Yes. That means from that, now they'll draw a conclusion, teacher is good, and the class will continue. You will draw a conclusion as well, teacher is good, I'll come to the class tomorrow also. But if the teacher is boring, teacher has just, you know, by-hearted the contents, teacher walks to the class like this and teacher turns around and says, good morning my dear students, I am here to teach you sociology. Let us begin. What sociology is? Sociology is study of society. It is also known as science of society. You know, I will start giving a lecture like, professors, you will have to get into, according to Karl Marx, society is nothing but, according to Emile Durkheim, sociology should look into studying the structures of society, institutions of society. Main pura gyan diye ja raha hu Max Weber ke hisab se. Sociology is, according to Max Weber, sociology is subjective understanding of objective reality. Therefore, sociology looks to study the meanings, motives and symbols associated with social action, the symbolic interaction in this had a view that the real meaning of sociology, the real motive of sociology is only to look at the symbols of social interaction. Kaisa lag raha hai ye lecture? How are you finding the lecture now? Bekar? Boring? So again, to those questions, in that case, if a lecture is like that, answer would be something else. Based on that, conclusion will be drawn. Teacher is bekar. So this, you know, the approach is just aise nahi ki randomly koi ek banda bola. For example, class has 30 students. ठीक है, अब उसमें अगर सारे 30 आर ऑन द सेम पेज देन इट इज ऑब्वियस डिसीजन. बट जनरली इन सोसाइटी डायनामिज्म एग्जिस्ट, राइट? सो मे बी 7 ऑफ यू वुड थिंक ही इज पुअर, ही इज पथेटिक टीचर. अनदर 30 ऑफ यू वुड थिंक ही इज वंडरफुल टीचर. इन एंड दे विल ऑल्सो लुक एट डिग्री ऑफ यू नो praise that they have for a teacher. He's okay teacher, yes sir, we'll somehow manage, yeah. So they'll think he's an average teacher. Do we have better option? We'll change the teacher. They'll draw conclusion according to that. If you know there are 7 students who are unsatisfied because of some maybe technical reason, sir teacher is good but you know there was some problem with the interaction or you know something like that, then that issue has to be observed. So basically what I am trying to say, any conclusion which is being drawn is drawn with a scientific approach. Facts are collected, you know, then a pattern in facts are observed, and when you observe that, based on that you are coming to a conclusion and then you are taking a decision. This is scientific study and this is systematic study. Clear? All of you, are you guys clear now? I hope you guys are clear. I hope you guys noted this down. We'll move to the we'll not waste time now, and we'll move to the next definition, which is scientific method. So you need to understand what scientific method is. So write a definition for it quickly. Please write definition for scientific method now. Now this is dictation so that you can make some notes as well. Now it's a standard definition, you can write it under quotation if you want. Please write in your notebook. Scientific method is a, please write. Please write in your notebook. Scientific method is a systematic and objective. Scientific method is a systematic and objective attempt to study. Scientific method is a systematic and objective attempt to study a problem. Objective attempt to study a problem for the purpose of deriving general principles, for the purpose of deriving general principles. अल्टीमेटली तुम लोग एक प्रिंसिपल बना रहे थे ना इस टीचर के बारे में, एक एब्स्ट्रैक्शन, ये टीचर अच्छा है या घटिया है. व्हेन यू ड्रू कंक्लूजन अल्टीमेटली यू हैड अ प्रिंसिपल, यू हैव एन आइडिया, यू हैड अ जनरलाइजेशन. यही है साइंटिफिक मेथड. आई विल रिपीट द डेफिनेशन वंस अगेन फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू. क्लियर? साइंटिफिक मेथड इज अ सिस्टमैटिक एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव अटेम्प्ट. Scientific method is a systematic and objective attempt to study a problem, for the purpose of deriving general principles, for the purpose of deriving general principles. Are we clear? For the purpose of deriving general principles, ठीक है? इसका flow chart समझते हैं, क्या होता है इसमें? Scientific method. Oh, sorry. Now, first of all, what happens in scientific method is that for anything, you know, there are features of scientific method. You have to understand that. How can you call that whether this method is scientific or not? It will look into characteristics. It will look into characteristics. ठीक है? It will look into characteristics. If you are using scientific method to study anything, it will look into characteristics. Okay. Once it looks into characteristics, it basically derives object. These are features of scientific method. So while I write on the board, you keep writing in your notebook as well. Let us not waste time, guys. Objectivity. Obviously, objectivity has to be there. And when I say scientific method, all of you people would have done your school mein labs 6, 7th, 8, 9, 10th, at least 10th tak to sabke science hai. Biology lab, chemistry lab, physics lab. We used to say aim, we used to write aim. Apparatus required, method, and finally observations. And at the end, conclusion. To wo aim likhte the, what was that? Objective tha. And apparatus required, ye sab, you used to define all that. So that within, you used to define a parameter so that you stick to that parameter. You eliminate all the biases in conducting the study. And the study is objective in nature. It is, it holds its objectivity. Clear? So second after characteristic is objectivity. It looks into characteristics of the study and objectivity. Okay? Verifiability. Scientific method kya karta hai? Aim hota tha. Whether Shekhar is a good teacher or Shekhar is a bad teacher. Who is Shekhar? Shekhar is standing straight. He is an entity. You are going to study. So, you will derive a hypothesis. Let's say Shekhar is a bad teacher. ठीक है? So, this is a hypothesis. Shekhar is a bad teacher. Now, you are conducting a scientific study to figure out whether this Shekhar is a good teacher or a bad teacher. Okay? So, scientific method allows verification, verifiability. Scientific method always allows verifiability. It will give you that space. I'm just looking at the phone. If you people have any doubt, do let me know. We need to keep the session very interactive. At the same time, we also need to maintain the pace. Varna syllabus kaise complete hoga? I don't believe in wasting time. Verifiability. Ab can I give all of you this task? Can you think of when I have mentioned about objectivity and verifiability? Let's make the class interactive and interesting. Let's participate. Why don't you teach me? Kuch aa raha hai, next connection kya ho sakta hai? Feature of scientific method, characteristic of scientific method. Can both of you, any one of you, tell me what is characteristic of scientific method? कोई बात नहीं. Classification. Scientific method में we do classifications. Good or bad एक तरह का classification है. Student और teacher there is classification. ठीक है. Reliability. Scientific method should be reliable. So reliability is another reliability. If you are following all these features, you are verifying something, you know, through your method something can be verified, classified, or it can be made reliable. And if your method is reliable, then it should be able to draw a conclusion. Therefore, next would be predictability. Next feature or characteristic of scientific method is predictability. Predictability. All these content आपको किसी book में नहीं मिलेगा, ठीक है? So I am building this base initially. At the initial stage, this base will be built, ठीक है? थोड़ा सा, फिर I'll teach you first unit, then we'll start with the second unit, third unit. You guys have to do it yourself initially. I will be providing you some materials because that is not to be taught it much. It is very objective. It's very straightforward, direct question. Wo ratta mar type ka topic hai, which is research methodology. ठीक है, and then we'll move to social thinkers. ठीक है, so let me get back to where I was. Predictability. What would be the last feature of scientific method? Any idea? Last feature, guys. Comparison and general. Predict हुआ, उसके बाद comparison तो कर सकते हैं ना. You were comparing me to maybe a teacher of different subject. और डिफरेंट टीचर ऑफ द सेम सब्जेक्ट. साइंटिफिक मेथड कंपैरिजन करने के लिए भी इनेबल होना चाहिए. तो कंपैरिजन एंड देन फाइनली जनरलाइजेशन. ठीक है, एंड इन ऑल दिस ओवरआर्चिंग फैक्टर इज कॉजल इफेक्ट एनालिसिस. दिस इज व्हाट द पर्पस ऑफ या कंक्लूजन. Good, good, Namira, very good. Predictability didn't get you. Okay, Saurabh. What is predictability? Science, you're conducting a study to come to a conclusion, to make a prediction. See, there are, in general, you would have studied logical reasoning, or in your school days, you would have learnt about two way to approach body of knowledge. One is inductivism, another is reductionism, isn't it? Deductionism, isn't it? So what happens in deduction? In case of deduction, there is already a hypothesis. There is already a hypothesis. And then you test it through observation. And based on that, you make a conclusion or inference ki yes, the certain hypothesis which we were testing successfully test. This method is deduction. There is another way of pursuing knowledge, induction. What is inductive method? What happens in inductive method? In inductive method, you look at various observation and based on that you build a theory. Isse tumko kya samajh mein aata hai? What do you understand from this? Scientific method doesn't just mean about being logically deductive, doing deduction. It also means about doing induction. For example, say today if you are checking wavelength of light, you already know, someone has proven it, and in your physics lab through microscope, you will be just testing it. So you are doing the validation of existing theory. But say if you were Isaac Newton, you saw an apple falling and from that you come to a conclusion of, after lots of observations, you will come to a conclusion that law of gravitation, universal law of gravitation exists between two bodies. Before Newton, there was no such identification. It was a new theory for the world. So whenever you construct a new theory, new body of knowledge, you need inductive method. If you are testing already existing body of knowledge, you will use deductive method. Hai ki nahi? Therefore, scientific method also need to have this feature, predictability. Induction mein hoga na, predict karoge, tum ek theory banaoge based on observation. So you are predicting something. Now did you get me? You had typed predictability, didn't get you. I hope now you got me. Please give me this confirmation, Saurabh. And let's move forward. Let us not waste much of time. Let's move forward. Chalo, good beta, good. Ha, so where were we? We were discussing scientific method. So basically this is scientific method. Scientific method khatam ho gaya. All these were features of scientific method. And ye kya karta hai? Causal effect analysis karta hai. Ya fir reliability. What, how can you check anything's reliability? Any study's reliability, how can you check? By evaluating cause effect relationship. There was a batsman in Team India called Rahul Dravid. In test matches, he was identified as Mr. Dependable, Mr. Reliable. Why? Because when you analyze, you do the cause effect analysis, then you will figure out why is he called reliable, how is he reliable, considered reliable. Because if you go to overseas condition where balls are swinging or bounce is steep, he'll at least, you know, face 100 to 100 balls, he'll not throw his wicket, the shine of the ball will lose and it will be easy for other batsmen to bat. So if anyone else throws his wicket, he may still stand the ground. So cause or effect pakde, usse nikla reliability. Clear? So this is scientific method. Now we'll move to social behavior. Definition mein teesra kya tha? Human behavior in social context. So let's look at what is social behavior. Now we'll not waste time. We need to move quickly. Theek hai? Social behavior. So please write. Please write. I'll dictate. Please write. All the ways of acting or all the ways of action, all the ways of acting or all the ways of action that influences or is influenced, that influences or is influenced by the other member of social group or society, by the other member of social group or society. Clear? Once again, I'll repeat this for you people. Please write if you've missed it. All the ways of acting or action, all the ways of action that influence or gets influenced by, that influences or gets influenced by the other member of social group or society is social behavior. एग्जाम्पल दिया था ना, थर्स्टी पानी पिया, इंडिविजुअल बिहेवियर, बिकॉज एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम शेखर वॉज एक्टिंग लाइक अ बायोलॉजिकल बीइंग, बट जैसे ही ही हैड अ डिफरेंट मोटिव, ही गॉट इन्फ्लुएंस्ड दैट नो नो यू हैव टू कीप योर थ्रोट मिस्ड सो दैट better delivery in the classroom needs to be done. So this decision got influenced by your presence, social behavior, getting influenced by other member of society. You're listening to me, focusing. I told you people, initially you, I was not receiving any message from you all. I requested you time and again, please whenever you find out, please WhatsApp me, please WhatsApp me. I'll try my best to clear all that doubt, all those doubts, isn't it? You believed in that, you got influenced by me, social action, you pinging me of for asking your doubt, social behavior, that's it. So we have understood social behavior through examples we had already discussed. Now we'll just move forward. Social group, I have already explained you this also about a social group. Social group, quickly we'll come to social group. Please write social group. Say there are only two students in the class today. One is Namira. I guess Namira is your name, right? Yeah, it's Namira. One is Namira, other is Saurabh. Say there are only two students in this class, therefore in that case what will happen? In that case, Namira, are you part of social group? If there are only two members, are they part of social group? Yes, even if you are two people just, you are still part of a social group. So one member interacting with other member and existing in one similar social setting, that is enough for a social group to be formed. For example, this is class, three members, two students, both pursuing civil services, both pursuing, both are aspiring civil services. Both are aspiring civil services, isn't it? And both have commonality, both have sociology as an optional, and both have enrolled in my class, have vested their trust in this individual. Or maybe you would not have known about me, but KSG the institution, the brand. So what do we mean over here? What do we understand from this? You both have common social setting and you have been drawn together. So you both formed a group and you are interacting in similar social setting, interacting with each other. So please write, please write. Two or more individuals, two or more so individuals who interact with one another, two or more individuals who interact with one another share similar characteristics. Similar characteristics, UPSC ki tayari kar rahe ho, sociology optional hai. Share similar characteristics and collectively have a sense of unity. And collectively have a sense of unity. Abhi to group nahi ban paye ho, aaj to first day hai. Kuch din baad tum do hi rahoge, lekin ek sense of unity aa jayegi. क्योंकि सोशल सेटिंग सेम है. आई रिपीट द डेफिनेशन फॉर यू, जस्ट बेयर विद मी. कोविड डेज तो बीच बीच में हैंड सैनिटाइज करना जरूरी हो जाता है. टू और मोर इंडिविजुअल्स हु इंटरैक्ट विथ वन अनदर and share similar characteristics and exist in collectivity and sense of unity are known as social groups and exists in collectively and sense of unity are known as social groups. Ab tumhare dimag mein aayega, sir, to explain us you had used the word social setting, but I don't see any in the definition, I don't see social setting, this word anywhere in the definition, right? To bacche, wo to main aapko samjhane ke liye bata raha tha, but once a group is formed doesn't mean the playground for group has to be similar. For example, I'm an Indian, my sister is in US, even she is an Indian. Social settings different hai, but we are belonging to the same group. Abhi ke liye social setting different hai, but we are belonging to the same group. Isiliye baad mein social setting, jab pehli baar group form ho raha tha us waqt mein ek social setting same tha, but group form ho gaya and if I still consider myself member of that group, to social mera jo social setting hai, if that changes also, still group exists, persists to exist, group continues to exist. Very good example of that, clear? So that is why in definition there is no social setting. Now no doubts as of now, chalo let's move. Now we come to the next definition, which is social institution. Social institution, please write an interrelated system of social rules and norms, an interrelated system of social, an interrelated system of social roles and norms, social roles and norms, comma, organized around the satisfaction of an important social need, of an important social need or social function, or social function is known as social institution. I'll repeat this for you once again, please focus on this. An interrelated system of social roles, comma, norms, organized around the satisfaction of an important social need or social function, or social function. Theek hai, this is the definition. Now guys, social institution, basically they are organized. Acha, please write this line also over here. Please write this line also, this is also very important. They are organized pattern of beliefs. Please write, they are organized pattern of beliefs and behaviors that are centered. They are organized pattern of beliefs and behaviors that are centered and behaviors that are centered on the basic on the basic social needs, on the basic social needs. तो basically ये क्या कहना चाह रहा है, ये कह रहा है ऐसा interrelated system है, ठीक है, जो कि social role और norm को इस तरह से organize करता है कि वो सोसाइटी के किसी नीड को केटर कर रहा हो. आई टोल्ड यू फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन, आई डिडंट आई टेल यू फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ सोशल इंस्टीट्यूशन. वन रिलीजन, वन पॉलिटी और पॉलिटिक्स आई शैल से, first is religion, second is politics, what is next? I shall say economy, then education, at last but not least what shall it be? Religion, politics, economy, education, and then at last but not least family. Say there are five institutions as I told you people. Now what does the definition says? Definition says that it is an interrelated system. So are they connected amongst each other? Yes, they are. At times about religion you study, hai ki nahi, theek hai, you get educated by the family as well. The nation, the politics of your nation can influence education. ठीक है, what is the quality of influence can get in, what is the quality of education can also depend on the economic situation of a nation. है कि नहीं, ये education को example ले रहा हूं. ऐसे ही सब कुछ, economy, Japan did not have any resources, still it excelled, did lack natural resources, still it had economically excelled so well. Why? Because Japan had invested in, आपने 9th class की या 10th class की economics की NCERT में पढ़ी होगी बचपन में, Japan had excelled because they were able to invest in human capital. Investment of in human capital, what does that mean? Economics का concept है, that means investment in health and investment in education. तो education से भी economy को फायदा हो सकता है, इंटर रिलेटेड. थ्रू एजुकेशन रिलीजियस रिफॉर्म्स कैन बी ब्रॉट, और यू नो यू कैन लर्न अबाउट रिलीजन, इट इज रिलेटेड, वाइस वर्सा. एजुकेटेड लोग आने लगेंगे पॉलिटिक्स में तो देश की पॉलिटिक्स चेंज होगी, देश की पॉलिटिक्स चेंज होगी तो ऑटोमेटिकली पॉलिटी विल ऑल्सो चेंज, बेटर बिल्स will come, better discussions in parliament will be seen, theek hai. And if female member pehle educated nahi hoti thi, if female member is educated as well, you will see better nurturing of a child. So education is also related to family. Any of these five institutions are related to each other. That is why it has started with the word, the definition had started with the word interrelated. Yes, yes, Namira, very good. That is why I just got your ping now. Education, economy, and family you had written. Very good, Namira. So that is why the definition had started with this word interrelated system. Are we clear? Now, of social roles, education has one role to play in society, politics has one role to play society. Inter roles or within family, daughter has one role against a father. Same Namira, to her father she is a daughter and one role has been assigned to her. At the same time to her brother she is a sister and a separate role has been assigned to her. Taking example of Namira, I am just making you understand this. Theek hai? So through this, what do we understand? Through this we understand that it is quite true that it is interrelated system, and then what is it doing? Ultimately, it organizes itself in such manner that it is constraining upon, it is ensuring that patterns of society exist, so that need of society is fulfilled. How? There are five institutions. Family, what is it doing? What is it catering? Determining kinship. Initial nurturing, serving need of society. It is need of society. That is why it is existing. Have you ever thought that? What is education doing? Have you ever thought what is education doing? Transmitting knowledge. Education is transmitting knowledge. Education is a social institution and it is doing something. It is transmitting knowledge. That is need of society. Hai na aapke definition mein, maine likhaya hai na. Social need or social function, important social need and important social function ko it satisfies. Dekh lo, karta hai. Economy, allocation of resources. Politics, governance. Religion, spiritual answer to spiritual and metaphysical question. Answering spiritual, at times moral also, and metaphysical question. So, all of them, these jo niche likha hai, they are needs of society. And it is catering that only. That's it. Any doubt? People, all of you, any doubt? Anushka, do you have any doubt? Anushka, do you have any doubt? Let me know if you people have any doubt as such. Theek hai? Ye bhi ho gaya. Ab kya bacha? Social structure. Let's understand. What is social structure? Let us understand what is social structure. Please write. First write the definition, then I'll explain you. Please write. Distinctive stable arrangement. Distinctive stable arrangement of institution, distinctive stable arrangement of institution whereby human being in society, distinctive stable arrangement of institution whereby human being in society interact and live together. Whereby human being in society interact and live together. And live together. Basically, social structure is nothing but organization of society. It is nothing but organization of society. It is nothing but organization of society. Clear? I'll repeat the definition once again for you people. Please write. It is distinctive stable arrangement. Distinctive stable arrangement of institution whereby human being in society interact. Human being within a society interact and live together. And live together. Clear? Bataya na Varna system, that was one style of social structure. Economic social structure, class, upper class, middle class, lower class, above poverty line, below poverty line, based on economic situation. तो उसमें भी क्या है? It is a stable arrangement. Now, there are one school of thought in sociology exists. These people are functionalist. These people are functionalist. Now, what does functionalist think? People coming from functional background or functionalist school of thought or functionalism for that matter, you know, that ideology says that whatever arrangement or structure of society is only exist in order for that society to function properly. If and they see all these existing parameters as pre-necessity condition for society to exist. Definition in a stable arrangement, distinctive stable arrangement. तो उनका कहना क्या है कि boss, this structure in society exists because society that way will remain stable. So, ये logic देके they justify existing social inequality in society. For them, inequality exists because meritocracy has to prevail in a society for society to exist. ठीक है, they will justify all the existing dysfunctional aspect of society as well. Those set of people are called functionalists. आगे फिर theoretical strands जब हम लोग पढ़ेंगे तो आप एक बार पढ़ोगे. आज दो concepts तो मैंने आपको अलग से बता दिए. Positivist, positivism, positivism, that belief, that ideology where an individual believes, where you know, an individual, a researcher who studies society believes that society should be interpreted or understood using scientific approach, similar to how physical sciences use an approach to understand element of society. Ye hai positivists. Baad mein inke oppose karne ke liye they'll come another set, school of thought. They'll be non-positivist. We'll all study that in unit 2, sociology as science. Abhi se bar bar isliye bol raha hu that it will reiterate in your mind so that understanding becomes easy. Clear? Are we clear? I hope we are. So, social structure ho gaya. Now, kya bacha? Social interaction. These things are not explicitly mentioned in your syllabus, guys. I'm only, your syllabus starts from modernity. But I'm only doing this क्योंकि ये समझोगे तो सब कुछ समझना आसान रहेगा. ठीक है? What do you mean by? I'm just trying to clear, you know, develop this understanding of all these jargons. एक बार ये clear हो जाएगा, we'll get into modernity. Social interaction. Let me see if the time is going to allow me to start modernity today. We have another half an hour of class. Let me see if we are able to start modernity today. Okay, where was I? I was at social interaction. Social interaction is, you know, large number of behavior. It is large number of behavior. Behavior at a large scale. Which has certain parameters. The first and foremost parameter coming out of this is exchange. Saurabh is asking for class notes to Neha. They are interacting. So one can interact when there exists exchange in society. If two groups exchange, there is interaction. Or when I say exchange, doesn't mean only physical exchange of thoughts, exchange of ideology, then also members of society, they are interacting. So exchange at any level. First, exchange. Second, competition. Now tell me something. Maybe Saurabh and Namira never talk to each other. Why? Because both of them appear to be highly competitive. They don't talk to each other, they compete against each other. Because they feel that, you know, both of them are in sociology. And the person appearing or sitting beside Saurabh could fetch the rank or could beat Saurabh in fetching the rank. Then therefore Saurabh gets competitive, and the similar attitude is adopted by Namira as well. They don't talk to each other. That doesn't mean they are not interacting. Competition is also a level of interaction. Through competition they are interacting. Namira ko kahin se pata chala, yaar Saurabh na test ke answers achhe likh raha hai yaar. Saurabh ko अराउंड 120 आ रहे हैं हर पेपर में आउट ऑफ 250. मैं जान लगा के पढ़ूंगा. सौरभ कितने घंटे पढ़ता है यार? सौरभ 6 घंटे पढ़ता है, मैं 9 घंटे पढ़ूंगी. आई विल रीड फॉर 9 आवर्स. ऑल्दो शी इज नॉट टॉकिंग टू सौरभ डायरेक्टली, सौरभ गेट्स टू नो अमीरा इज लुकिंग टू बीट मी. शी इज स्टडिंग फॉर 9 आवर्स, आई विल स्टडी फॉर 12 आवर्स. सी योर बिहेवियर getting guided by someone else's action, although you both are not talking to each other, interaction ho raha hai, but aapke beech mein competition. This is another way of interaction, social interaction. Theek hai? Shikhar sir is boring or he is too theoretical. Acha, Shikhar sir abhi boring nahi hai, but मान लो कुछ ऐसा टॉपिक आएगा जिसमें ज्यादा समझाने को नहीं है, बस रट्टा मार टॉपिक है, उसमें एनीवन विल लुक बोरिंग. ठीक है, ही जस्ट कम हियर, गिव यू कंटेंट एंड वॉक अवे. देन व्हाट विल हैपन, यू मे नॉट अंडरस्टैंड लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. से सौरभ हैड नॉट अंडरस्टूड सो मेनी थिंग्स, फातिमा हैज अंडरस्टूड. फातिमा विल टीच सौरभ और सौरभ विल आस्क फॉर हेल्प and they'll help each other. That is what an action of cooperation. So third element of, third tenet of social interaction is that of cooperation. Fourth is conflict. As Marx says, according to Marx, in capitalist system, the capitalist system is divided in two classes. One is that of bourgeois, other is that of proletariats, and both these classes exist in conflict with each other. So basically he believes that one class of society, in order to flourish, will exploit the another. Interest of one class of society exists in conflict with other side class of society. और कॉन्फ्लिक्ट तो ऐसे भी सोसाइटी में दो इंडिविजुअल के बीच में भी हो सकता है, दो ग्रुप के भी बीच में हो सकता है कि नहीं? कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इज ऑल्सो अ मोड ऑफ इंटरेक्शन. लास्ट कोवर्सन, कोवर्शन। कोवर्शन क्या होता है? देखो, पावर, ठीक है, पावर बेसिकली क्या होता है? व्हाट इज पावर गाइस? पावर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट वेयर वन्स विल इज इंपोज्ड ऑन अदर। वन्स विल इज इंपोज्ड ऑन अदर। मोदी जी और उनके गवर्नमेंट का बिल था फार्मर्स, फार्म रिफॉर्म्स बिल लाना, ले आए और पास करवा दिया और वह देश का कानून बन गया। सो ही इज पावरफुल बिकॉज ही इज एबल टू इंपोज हिज विल ऑन मी। इन दिस क्लास हु इज पावरफुल? आई एम पावरफुल। आई एम वॉट एवर आई वॉन्ट टू टीच, हाउ एवर आई वॉन्ट टू टीच, आई एम टीचिंग इट। I am powerful, I am imposing, these are my understandings of the subject and I am imparting it on you. I am the powerful one, my will is being imposed on you. But then there is difference. If you have allowed me to do this, then I become authority and then my power is legitimate. है कि नहीं? यू हैव एनरोल्ड इन माई क्लास, यू आर रेडी टू लर्न फ्रॉम मी, दैट मीन्स दैट यू हैव अलाउड मी टू टीच यू, यू हैव अलाउड मी टू यू नो इम्पोज माई विल ऑन यू। वी हैव इलेक्टेड मोदी जी एज आर प्राइम मिनिस्टर, देयरफॉर वी हैव अलाउड हिम टू इम्पोज हिज विल ऑन अस। दैट इज वाई गवर्नमेंट, a government is considered as legitimate authority. But then hafta vasooli karne aata hai, there also tumko bolega beta paise de, yahan ready lagaya chal paise de. Now you, he is acting powerful, he is applying his will on you and you have to act accordingly. But you have not allowed that, you have not given that permission, therefore his power is not legitimate, it is illegitimate. The illegitimate exercise of power of one individual over other is coercion. Taliban, Afghanistan mein pehle conflict hua, interaction hua and ab log bole kya aage government form karo? Nahi, khud se le liya, hathiya liya aur government form kar raha hai. They are being coercive in nature. So last element of interaction is coercion. Clear? So we are done with social interaction as well. Please, time to time I am checking my phone, WhatsApp. So if you have got any problems, do let me know. Now we will just look into pattern of society, then society ka ek do definition likhenge and we are done with understanding all the elements of sociology's definition. To fir aap logo basic samajh mein aayega ki kya kya hai subject matter, then we'll get into the first unit which is modernity, patterns of society. Patterns of society, guys, what is patterns of society? Something that you observe, ठीक है, some every 5 minutes this gentleman is drinking water, although there is no water as such. So as soon as the class will conclude, this gentleman will rush to bathroom. This is a pattern. But this pattern belongs to an individual's action. You all are going to be student of sociology. So, एक social pattern के बारे में हमें bother करना है. Social pattern. Social pattern basically puts pressure on individual in selecting their choices. For example, Bachelor? See, I am a bachelor. Although I am faculty, I am gentleman, I am above 18, I am above 32. Okay. I may not be a civil servant student. Now I go to a landlord, ask for a room or a flat. They'll ask me a question, are you a bachelor? No, 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 we don't give to bachelors. Will girls come to your place? I may say yes. I am 32, maybe I may be having a girlfriend or I may be having wife, depends, it's my personal choice. But then I'll, if I may feel that, if I'll be honest, that yes, my girlfriend may visit my place from time to time, then I may not get the room. So I'll say, no uncle, no girlfriend, I'm bachelor. Only my parents will come and one or two friends will come. Do you smoke? No uncle, I don't smoke. Do you drink? No uncle, I don't drink. I sleep by 10 o'clock in the night. These are existing patterns, the norms, values, patterns they derive from norms and values of society, and I am only trying to confirm to it. So basically, patterns of society, they constrain individuals in making their choices. They put pressure on people to select their choice, so to select one choice over other. They put pressure on people to select one choice over other. Now, they have social meanings and motives associated with them. Meri mom, jab gaon jaati hain, apne sasur and saas ke saamne ghoongat and parda karti hain. It's a pattern of society. Theek hai? And guys, in general, main aap logon ko ek instruction de raha hoon. When you study sociology, no value biasness. We are not studying politics, we are studying society. You have to study it like a scientist. No value biases, with value neutrality, with neutral value neutrality, with that attitude we will study the subject. That is demand of the subject. Clear? Are we clear? I hope we are. So, ab meri mom ghoongat taanti hai, that's a culture. Theek hai? So, she is conforming to a pattern. So pattern of society, ya fir pitaji kehte the na 10 baje raat ko so jana, in someone's family people sleep at 10, people wake at 4, there are other set of family people wake by 6, people sleep by 12. So wo apni patterns hai, but wo pattern individual ke choice ko drive to kar rahi hai na, it is putting pressure on individual making choice of one over other. That is pattern of society. Clear? 30 के हो गए हो बेटा, शादी कर लो वरना शादी नहीं होगी, मेरे ऊपर ये प्रेशर पुट किया जा रहा है, चॉइस शुड बी माइन. सो पैटर्न ऑफ द सोसाइटी इज कि बाय 30 वन शुड बी अर्निंग गुड, शुड हैव हिज ओन होम एंड शुड बी मैरिड. इफ आई डोंट ऑप्ट टू गेट मैरिड, आई एम डेवियंट इन सोसाइटी, आई एम नॉट कंफर्मिंग टू द पैटर्न ऑफ सोसाइटी, सो आई विल बी कॉल्ड अ डेवियंट. डेवियंस थ्योरी, आरके मर्टन is in your syllabus. He is social thinker, unit 4. He is the fifth thinker which you are going to study after Talcott Pearson. All of them will study in detail. Please, syllabus ke through, you people should go through. Theek hai? But ye example de raha hu, this is pattern of society. Done. Now come to the last word, society. Let's come to the last word. Society. What is society in general? Just bear with me. Pani pilu. सोसाइटी इन जनरल, कभी सोचा है बचपन से सोसाइटी के बात हो? सी, सोशियोलॉजी इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी अ न्यू सब्जेक्ट टू यू. यू हैव बीन पार्ट ऑफ सोसाइटी सिंस योर चाइल्डहुड, सिंस यू टुक बर्थ. फ्रॉम द टाइम यू हैव टेकन बर्थ, यू हैव बीन पार्ट ऑफ योर फैमिली. So you've been part of a social institution. So somehow society has always, you have always seen society, you have always known about society, but when you've come to this class of sociology, so now you have decided that now I'll study it academically. That's the only difference. But you've already always studied it. ठीक है. बेसिक लेवल पे सोसाइटी को अंडरस्टैंड करना है तो सोसाइटी इज वेब ऑफ रिलेशनशिप एंड इज ऑलवेज चेंजिंग. प्लीज राइट ऑल दीज डेफिनेशंस. सोसाइटी इज वेब ऑफ रिलेशनशिप and is always changing. Clear? Society is web of relationship and is always changing. But then society ke bare mein aur sari baatein ho sakti hai. Theek hai. सोसाइटी कहां एग्जिस्ट करती है? हाउ डू यू कंफर्म दैट यू बिलोंग टू वन पर्टिकुलर सोसाइटी? सी, सोसाइटी इज नॉट फॉर्म्ड बाय ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. यू आर ह्यूमन बीइंग्स बट यू आर ऑल्सो अ सोशल बीइंग. सो सोसाइटी एग्जिस्ट ओनली वेयर सोशल बीइंग बिहेव टुवर्ड्स ईच अदर as mutually as expected behavior. That behavior towards each other is set on an expectation, certain expectation which is mutually recognized. What I am trying to say is that definition deta hu, try to understand. Society only exists when social beings, man as a social animal, behavior of these social being towards each other is conforming to the certain expectation of behavior. Indian society recognizes one expectation of behavior, which is this expectation of behavior towards each other of two social beings is mutually recognized. That is when we say that society exists. ठीक है. So write this. Please write this. Now I'll dictate. Please write this. Society exists only where. Please write. Society exists only where social beings behave towards one another. Social beings behave towards one another in ways determined by their expected mutual recognition. In ways determined by their expected mutual recognition, their expected mutual recognition. Clear? Socho, society human beings tak limited hai kya? Socho. No, society is not limited just to human beings. Bees, ants, ऑब्जर्व किया है, एंट स्कूल में पढ़े थे ना बचपन में, दे फंक्शन और दे एग्जिस्ट इन सोसाइटीज. सो सोसाइटी इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट विच इज नॉट जस्ट लिमिटेड टू ह्यूमन बींग्स. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट. नाउ एक सोशल थिंकर है मैकाइवर एंड पेज. I am going to dictate their definition. Please write. and please be fast while I dictate this. Take care. According to McIver and Page, please write. According to McIver and Page, society is a system of usage. According to McIver and Page, society is a system of usage and procedure of authority. Society is a system of usage and procedure of authority and mutual aid of many groupings and divisions, of many groupings and divisions, of controlling of human behavior, of controlling of human behavior, and of liberties. This ever changing complex system we call as society. So this was complete quotation statement of McIver and Page. We call society. I'll repeat this for you once again. Please write. Society is a system of usage. A procedure and of authority and mutual aid of many groupings and divisions of controlling of human behavior and of liberties. Kiske behavior ko kaise derive karna hai, drive karna hai, ya fir kiski liberty ko kitna curtail karna hai. Of liberties, full stop. This ever changing complex system we call society. Clear? So that is about society. I was just seeing if you guys have any doubt. So that's all for today, guys. We'll stop it over here, because abhi agar ab main modernity shuru karunga to koi fayda nahi hai. Hum log kal modernity se shuru karenge, first unit is sociology, the discipline, that has 3 chapters. Very first chapter is modernity, change in Europe and emergence of sociology. So what is modernity? What changes of Europe I am referring to and how it helped in emergence of sociology, that we'll read tomorrow, that will be dealt tomorrow, and then there will be class on Saturday as well, and then second chapter of first unit is what is the second chapter of first unit? Achha, you guys haven't seen the syllabus, so you won't know. Okay, I'll send syllabus to you all. If necessary, we may have a conversation today evening. Theek hai? Second unit is comparison of social sciences and scope of sociology. So we'll go through it as well. And then sociology as common sense. So we'll look to finish these topics by Sunday. and then from Monday we'll have sociology as science, which is unit 2. Theek hai, that's all. Do you all have any doubts? If you've got doubts, then do let me know. People, can you confirm if you've got any doubts? People, can you confirm if you've got any doubts? And I hope you guys had enjoyed my style of teaching. You enjoyed the class, had fun. I hope I was not boring you people down. I was not draining your energy. It did not sound like traditional lecture kind of class. I'd see, we are living in this COVID situation where we can't have live interactive class, offline classes. But I hope, considering at my best level, I had maintained this decorum of making class as interesting and as interactive I could. That is how I teach, that is how my style is. That's all for today. Keep studying hard. Okay. Stay safe, very important in COVID days. Okay. That's all. Thank you and have a nice day, guys. Take care. We'll meet tomorrow, same timing, 1 o'clock. Thank you and have a nice day. Take care. Bye-bye. You both of you have got my number. Now you guys know. During the class, you people, all of you, you will have to ping me on my number. This is how we will do. And in general also, if you have got any doubt as such about the subject or topics, you can contact me. You guys have got my number. I will save your number as well. Thank you. That's all. Thank you and have a nice day. Take care. Bye-bye.